Hi everyone, and welcome to my channel ShutterBug Infinity. So today I'm doing a review, and I'll also have some photos and videos from this lens. It's the Canon EF 100-400mm 4.5-5.6 USM lens. So it is a push-pull system compared to the Mark II, which has a rotary zoom. So the touch resistant ring allows you to specify how easy or hard it is to push pull. The tight setting allows you to lock in the lint and prevent the lens from dropping when taking a photo. And the smooth allows you to adjust the lint with ease. So here I'm moving the focus ring, and you can tend to move together. So next up, I will show you the image stabilization buttons. So there is two modes. So mode 1 corrects vibration in all directions and is effective in shooting still subjects. And mode 2 corrects vertical camera shake when the lens is moving in horizontal plane and corrects horizontal camera shake. The lens is moving a vertical plane. So here I have an example of mode 1. And here you can see in the second video, it's a little more shakier. So that is with stabilization off. Next up, I will show you the autofocus and manual focus button. And here you have focal distance. So for focal distance, either 1.8 meters to infinity or 6.5 meters to infinity. Focal distance is only going to work when autofocus is turned on. So by correctly setting the distance range prior to shooting, you're enabling the lens to shorten the autofocus time. So here's a photograph I took on autofocus of the daffodil, and here I put on manual focus. So this camera lens takes a 77mm filter, the same as the Mark II. So I'm just demonstrating the focus ring, and I have to hold the second ring so it doesn't move. So next up, I'll show the tripod mount. So the orientation locking knob allows you to go from landscape to portrait very easily. So it's very important you should mount your tripod to the lens and not the camera. If you mount the camera to the tripod, you lose the functionality. The camera and lens will be a very much more weighted to the front and can cause issues when trying to lock in a shot. So this lens can be susceptible to mold. So I think when extending the lens, moisture, air is being pulled into it. So it is good to try and keep it as dry as possible and allow it to air out after being in a human environment. At 100mm can get maximum aperture f4.5, and at 400mm maximum aperture f5.6. If your subject is 4 meters away, then you would choose 1.8 meters to infinity. And if subject is 8 meters away, then 6.5 meters to infinity. So this lens is lighter and narrower than the Mark II. The biggest difference is the zoom action, as this original one is a sliding, has 2 stops image stabilization, compared to the newer lens, Mark II has 4 stops up image stabilization. More than twice effective. So using slow shutter speeds, it's still able to keep a sharp image. As you can see here, I have another example of the sharp quality. So here is the lens hood. So the part number of the lens hood lines up with the top of the lens to grab the thread when storing the hood. And when using the hood facing forward, the part number is 1/4 turned to the left before it will catch the thread. So the length of the lens is 3.6 inches wide times 7.4 inches long at its shortest when it's closed and without the lens hood. So here with the lens hood attached, the length spans 11 inches and extended with hood and camera attached, it's 14 inches. These measurements are from the mount. This lens weighs 3 pounds. So both of these lenses, the Mark II and the original, take 77mm filters. But filters can slow down the autofocus and distract from the quality. The autofocus is faster on the Mark II and accurately is like more sharper and brighter compared to the original one. I'll have more examples of photographs coming up. I hope that if you have any questions, you let me know in the comment section below. I'll be happy to answer them. So here I show photographs of the birds at 400mm. Here is a photo of the pigeon, also at 400mm. This camera is great for wildlife photography. I also use it for landscape and seascapes. So it's a very versatile lens. So here I have the lens attached to my Canon 7D. So once again, my channel is all about photography and travel. So if you're into that, please consider subscribing. I appreciate you guys for watching. Hope you have a great day. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one.